morning, Beagle Comets, and welcome to the Beagle Broadcast. I am Aiden.
And I am Rowling.
Today is Friday, October 28, 2016. Please stand and face the flag for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. Happy birthday to Dakota in Mrs. Schuler's class, and Alay in Mrs. Kelly's class. Enjoy your day today. This weekend, Lucas in Mrs. Hillbrand's class, Gavin in Mrs. Kish's class, and Anna in Mr. Winter's class all have birthdays. Happy birthday to you all.
Here's some comet catchers from this week. Marky in Miss Lager's class was caught working hard with Mrs. Quick. Great job, Marky. Ava in Mr. Dunno's class was caught showing ownership when she was practicing her spelling words. You are awesome, Ava. Elliot in Mrs. Mullenkamp's class was showing kindness when he was partners with someone who didn't have one. You are a rock star, Elliot. Dayton in Mr. Snyder's class was caught giving 100% effort. Keep up the great work, Dayton. Anna in Mrs. Parrish's class was caught reading her books quietly after checking out her library books. Thank you for taking ownership, Anna. You rock, Comets. Here are a few words of wisdom.
Good morning, Beagle. This is Christopher with a few words of wisdom. The word duty has become an old-fashioned word, but it's a word we need to hear more of. Why? Because it's our duty to do what we ought to do. Some would say, what is your duty in life? Well, that's probably something you should discuss with a parent, counselor, or spiritual leader, but this is what American psychologist David Seabury says. Your only duty is to do the best you can. Today, let's do our duty by doing our personal best.
Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours. Have a very spooky Halloween.
This book is Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. It's about a kid named Harry Potter who lives in a cupboard for around 10 years, and then he moves out because he gets some suspicious letters from an unknown person that nobody knows. And then he goes to this school where he learns lots of wizardry, and he learns the world of magic. And he finds out that there's something suspicious going on, and that someone tried to kill him.
This book is called I Survived September 11, 2001. I really like it because it had a lot of action in it, and I actually learned something about it, is that I thought there was one plane that crashed, but there's actually two. They both crashed into one tower. And it's about this little boy. He's 14 years old. His dad's a firefighter, so is his uncle. His dad got seriously hurt, and they used to build a lot of models in the basement after dark. So he was really sad about that. And then, like, 3 days later, there's a huge fire up the Twin Towers. And his dad went to fight it, but he was somewhere else. So as soon as he heard about it, he rushed over there. His uncle was already there. And then the boy was in the firehouse. So the dad looked for him, but then he found him wandering through the streets looking for his uncle. And then his dad threw him inside a building because there was a big rumbling. And it was because the top of that building was about to crash down, but they survived, and that's
really good. I like this book, The Tales of the Beetle and the Bard, because it shows how they would have bedtime stories, and it has lots of humor and is from J.K. Rowling. So you have to find out the rest if you read the book.
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll This is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
They came from Africa on a trading ship. They settled in Virginia in 1619. They brought us cornbread and told folk tales. This land was made for you and me. They came from Asia to America. They crossed the land bridge to North America. They gave us jerky and the word teepee. This land was made for you and me.
They came from Asia on a boat. They settled for gold in California. They gave us sushi and made our railroads. This land was made for you and me.
They came from Europe across the ocean. They settled on the East Coast, 13 colonies. They gave us poetry and gave us waffles. This land was made for you and me.
They came from Spain looking for Asia. They settled in the Caribbean islands. They gave us Chile and the word hurricane. This land was made for you and me.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
Began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin.